Hey guys, this is Captain Charlemagne from Captain Charlemagne's Models. I'd like to thank you for joining me today. So let's head over to the bench and see what we're going to be doing for today's project. Hey guys, and welcome back to the bench. So today we're going to continue on working with USS Texas. So different from what we've been doing the last few episodes, I decided to move off from working on Texas's hull, because as of right now there's nothing much we can really do with it. I will point out that what we did over the course of the week is that we did put our LEDs in, and we did seal up the holes where the anchors go to help make sure there's no light bleeding where those are. But today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be focusing on parts for the bridge. So first thing we're going to need is the photo etch piece of 214, and we are going to be putting on two of them today to the bridge. And I don't think I opened this. So let's see if that has allowed us to put this on. I think I didn't do something wrong. Here. Especially considering this is a brand new thing of glue. Okay, there we go. I didn't have it all the way. Always make sure your stuff's completely ready before you start. You don't wanna do too much of a mistake. So, just small bit. There. And carefully get that on. That's one down. Okay. One down. Two more for that spot to go. So we're gonna put a hole in our mat. Go ahead and grab this one. Next, we are going to need the second 214. So, what reason was it that I stopped not doing anything with the hole today? And I'm focusing on this. Well, that's because the reason is I ran out of paint. I went to spray some haze gray parts and I ran out, and the paint will be until Friday. As such, to change gears on what it is I'm going to be doing. So I decided that today we'll do some stuff relating to the bridge. Okay. Second one is on. Next, what we are going to need to do is build up some letters. So, what we are going to need is 213. And lucky enough, it didn't fly, it could have flew. So, Jeffrey 1, Carpet Monster 0. And this piece, according to this, pardon me, I need to bring this closer to me because I can't see. According to this, goes back here on the back side. So when this goes on, it will go, according to this, right here. So, like we did before, put a little bit of our super glue, and then we're going to try and straighten it up. And hopefully it does not solidify on us or we get it into the corner. There we go. Right in the, let the camera get focused on the piece. As you can see, right there in the corner, that's our third piece of etch down. Next, we are going to be adding on 196. So, again, we're going hunting, and that would be right here. Carefully move the photo etch sheet off the spot for the moment. This is so I can start bending it. And I know I'm probably gonna have some people saying I'm bending the photo etch wrong. Okay. Then Okay, that's another piece down. Next, we're adding some more blue there. So this piece is going to go right here. See if I can't get better, zoom it in more. As you can see, another ladder down. Gonna bring back the photo etch part. Next, we're going to cut off our next ladder. Slip out. There we go. And you all can probably hear it in the background. The dog is being a big crybaby. Then. Same thing that we did before. Move the pieces up. Small amount of glue. A little bit more glue to the bottom of that one because of there. Alrighty then. Alright, another ladder down. Next, what we are going to need is we are going to need 212. So see if we can't locate it on here, right here. Thank you. almost flew away. Pretty much same steps as before. Hold this. Next, we're gonna fold the inches of this piece. Carefully. Try and get it on here without it going somewhere. There we go. With that, we got that one on. So, moving on. Next, we are going to work on adding some of the back railing. So, what we're going to need is 217. Now, locate that. These things are all over the place. Here we go. 217. Has a slight bend to it. Is it enough or is it too much? Slightly too big a bend. Alright. Following that, same process as before. There we go. That piece is on. Next, we're going to move over to the other side again. See if we can't find that same piece from before on this side, but this side. Let's see. Or is it labeled differently for the other side? Doesn't seem like it's labeled differently. So, first time I've played with Pontos, so trying to locate where every single piece is. Not counting all the pieces being numbers being smaller than even on traditional photo etch. Oh, that's why, because on this side, because I didn't tear off this piece, that the 17 is also part of 19. So hunt down to 19, which is this piece here. And what we are going to do is, first thing we're going to do is we're going to cut the piece completely out. Then photo etch piece down. Then give it a slight bend. Almost lost the piece. Okay. Alrighty then, piece has been made small enough. Voila, it is on. So, following on from there, what we are going to do is we are going to add in the ring pieces that go into that. So, first that requires us to locate them, which are right here. So, what we are going to need first is is 05. So locate 5, which is right here. Following that, we are going to take these little edges here and we are going to bend them down. I'm sorry if I'm not showing them on the thing. It's just that these edges are so small that they're very difficult. It'd be difficult to try and do it well on camera. I will say that I kind of do wish that they made a Texas in 1 in 200. To me, it would make playing with Photo Etch a whole lot easier. Hopefully it didn't fall in a place where I can't see it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to locate that piece real quick, and I will be right back in just a few moments. And we are back. So sadly, I was not able to locate that piece. It seems that the first piece of the day has been claimed by the carpet monster. So what I decide to do is, what we are going to do next is we are going to add on some of the we're going to finish off today by adding on a few of the ship's doors. So, first we're going to need doors in military, or they know they're more hatches. Next, we're going to add some glue. Seems that we had a piece come off. Anyway, we have our first door on. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to quickly, real quick, re-put on our that's back on. Next, we're going to need another hatch. Luckily, we did not lose that hatchway to the carpet monster. And it seems as if that one is trying to get itself lost. Also seems that I spoke too soon. Readjust my seat for a minute. Maybe I should get one of those office-type chairs. It'd be more comfortable than a freaking wicker chair I'm always using. Okay. go. Door number two. Hatch number two. And we are going to finish off today by adding the two hatches for this side. So let's get to it. And we got that one on. And that will conclude all that we're going to be doing for USS Texas today. So, I'd like to thank you all for joining me today. If you enjoy what you see and you want to keep up with the building of USS Texas, then please hit that notification bell to be updated on any future updates. And I wish you all a nice day, a nice week. And this is Captain Charlemagne, and I'm signing off. Godspeed, everyone.